Okay, good afternoon, everybody. Pastor Mike here, getting ready for midday prayer. Just making sure that things are live, and that sounds like they are. I'll give folks just a moment to join up, and we'll get started with our prayer time today. I hope you all are enjoying this day that the Lord has made and given over to us to be glad in, and let me know you're here. You can chime in on the in the comments. Also, if you'd like to include anyone in our prayers, please put their names in the comments as well, and I will include them as we go forward and when we get to that particular time in our prayer time together. I see Diane's with us. I think I saw that Mike was with us. So we have, Diane's here. We'll see who else may join us in just a second. And we'll get started. So we're going to begin as we center ourselves and we breathe in the breath of God. And we breathe out our cares and our concerns. And we breathe in the love of God. And we breathe out our doubts and our despairs. And we breathe in the life of God. And we breathe out our fears and our frustrations. So today, liturgically, is a feast we know we celebrate as Presentation of Our Lord. In other traditions, it's it may be also called Candlemas or Candlemas. It's in some traditions, this is the last day of Christmas. That's why I wore my Christmas sweater today. It's the day that, according to Jewish tradition, Jesus's parents, Mary and Joseph, would have taken him to the temple to be presented 40 days after his birth. So today, it's 40 days after Jesus's birth, there's several readings for today, but the one of them is one of the readings that was appointed for today is Psalm 84. And at least the superscription in my study Bible says, the joy of worship in the temple. The temple in Jesus' time was the center of God's presence on earth. And to make the pilgrimage up to Jerusalem for that presentation was a holy experience for Mary and Joseph. The folks there recognized that Jesus at that time is the source of their salvation. And there's lots of joy in that space. And, you know, I was still thinking about when I read the superscription for the psalm is how joyful it is in worship, and how joyful our experience is when we join together for worship. Or at least how I hope it's joyful for folks. So let's listen to the words of the psalmist as we hear from Psalm 84. I'm going to read the first four verses. How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord of hosts. My soul longs, indeed it faints, for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh sing for joy to the living God. Even the sparrow finds a home, and the swallow a nest for herself, where she may lay her young at your altars, O Lord of hosts, my King and my God. Happy are those who live in your house, ever singing your praise. So, talking about joyfulness in worship, I think one of the gifts of being called together as a worshiping community, whether that worshiping community meets physically in a space we may call a sanctuary or worship center, or if that community meets online as we are right now. But that it's the community that God builds, the connectedness, the way that God puts people in our lives and that we love and support one another. I think that is one of the greatest gifts of being a part of a worshiping community. And that love that we feel between ourselves is the same love that God has for all of us. And, I think there was no greater expression of God's love than God becoming one of us through Jesus, God's very self becoming a human, becoming part of creation itself, even in all of its brokenness, to show us what love might look like and how love can be enacted and how love can change lives and change the world. And my prayer every day is that that same love that we feel maybe within our little community of faith is a love that we can share with those in our lives, whomever we may meet, and in any way that we are able to do that. Sometimes we share that love with our neighbor through something physical, kind of actions such as, you know, feeding and making sure people have housing. That's a way to show love. Sometimes we show love for our neighbor by just simply being in their presence when they are struggling. We don't have to have the answers. We just have to be there. You know, a large portion of ministry in all of our lives is what's called a ministry of presence. It's knowing that I've got somebody that needs to be held together and needs to be accompanied, and that I am going to be part of that. That's the way I'm going to minister today. So our friends from Camp Hill are going to talk about this love, this great love, or sing about this great love. It is called "O Love That Will Not Let Me Go." And I think that's the love I hope we feel when we are gathered together for worship in whatever way we are, is that we feel God's love, that great love that will not let us go. And then we'll get back together and pray for folks. If you've got anybody you'd like to add to our prayers, please put their names in the comments, and I'll be glad to include them in that time. So here are our friends from Camp Hill, and we will get back together to pray. Oh, love that will not let me go. That is a gift that we get from God every day. It was a very happy and meaningful message from our friends in Camp Hill. So now let's get together to pray. Good and gracious God, this gift of your calling us together into a community of faith is one that is beyond our comprehension some days. It is a place where we can safely bring our whole selves, where we can know that we are loved just as we are, where we can be supported, where we can be healed, where we can simply be, if that's what we are called to do in this moment. So for that gift of that community and that gift of faith that comes with it, we do give you thanks, oh God. And when you call us together, you connect us in a way in which when our fellow disciples suffer, we suffer alongside them. We feel their pain. We know their joy. We know their grief. And we ask, God, that your healing presence would surround all of those who need to feel that presence this day. Peggy and Dan, Ryan and Jackie, Dustin Moretz, Lynn Behringer, Betty Karabanoff, John Boblitz, Beth Fowler, Pam Thorne, Jan Shank, Barbara Lincoln, Laura Dareth, Terry, Howard Fales, Rebecca Neal, Glenn Hardesty, Jane Cox, Sabrina, Ryan and Dave, Lynn Smith, Linda Heitzelman, Peggy Helwig, Ruby Gostel, Katie Lawrence, Tracy Strimple, Paul and Dawn, Brian Shaw, Jerry, Lynn Anderson, Mike, Bev Diaz, Connie Koss, Ernie, Keith Brown, Adam Hayes, Karen, Madeline Rubin, Stacy Allison, Carolyn Culp, Ed Ziegler, John, Belinda, Brianna, and Joshua, Cheryl Stradling, Liz, and those that we name aloud are silently in our hearts at this time. Your love survives even our death. In fact, our St. Paul writes that there is nothing in this world, including death, that can ever separate us from your great love. And through your son's resurrection, we're promised that we will live a resurrected life with you, surrounded and enveloped in that glorious love of yours. But even as we grieve, we also realize that life as we know it does come to an end before that resurrection happens. And so we ask, God, that you be with the family and friends of Keith Wagner, who died this week, and also with Lisa Anderson and her family at the death of Lisa's mom, Christine, just last evening, that those who are grieving and mourning might be comforted by your great love that will sustain them in the days ahead and will also keep them forever connected to the one that is now in your care and resting in your love. And now, God, as your people, we come together and we pray the words that our Lord Jesus taught his disciples to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. And now as we wrap up our time together, we will breathe in the breath of God. And we'll breathe out our tension and our turmoil. And we breathe in the love of God. And we breathe out our haste and our apprehensions. And we breathe in the life of God. And we breathe out our work and our worry. Again, it's great to be with you all today. Hope you have a great weekend. Remember, we have worship on Sunday morning, 9:30, both on-site and online. Deacon Peggy Hahn will be our preacher this week. She's here helping us do some strategic planning work. And then we'll also have a session after worship prayer, members of the congregation can be introduced to and be a part of that work as well. And then we'll be together for midday prayer Monday, Wednesday, and Friday of next week. Pastor Tamika will be with you on Monday and likely Wednesday. I'll be with you on Friday. And until then, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. God bless. Have a great rest of your day. And I'll see you when I see you.